The quill story.
So what do you think? What do you think we're gonna make?
Let's see the instructions. Mm-hmm. Cut out the triangles. Mm-hmm. Match the O to blue.
Mm-hmm. I know. Mm-hmm. I'm in a quill.
For green. And to G for. I don't know what G for, but I think this
one. G is for green. Mm-hmm. Or wait, yeah, G is for green. B is for blue. O is for orange.
Green.
And P is for pink. So do you see, Alejandro? Okay, this is going to be the blue square right here. So you're going to cut out four blue triangles from your little pieces, and you're going to put them right over top the letters, and they're going to make a pattern. All right, which color are you going to start with, Alejandro?
Orange.
Green? Okay. All right.
It's to cut it. Don't worry, I've got a hang of it here.
Yeah, I knew you would. I knew you would, my friend.
Hey, me feel better.
I'm glad you feel better.
What a relief.
None of your art projects is hard.
Oh, it is hard.
They're not hard at all.
Not hard at all.
Because your art supply, because there's supplies.
Cutting out a bunch of triangles, Alejandro. You can do it.
Like in the store of Michael's. Because they're clean. Okay, so up. What letter?
Okay. What color are you? What color paper are you cutting out, Alejandro?
Orange.
Orange matches with O. Oh. I think once you see the pieces go in, you'll see. Oh, neat.
Building music, please. Super Mario Maker theme going? Song theme. Ding ding. And Super Mario Maker 2.
Here we go, Alejandro.
Hey, Alejandro, you're so happy on Friday afternoons that you hum and sing every time.
Can you hear the music I'm playing?
Okay, I've done my first one. Do you see what it looks like when you match the triangle in the right spot?
Okay. Mm. It makes a diamond. Wrong picture.
How are you doing, Brendan? You cutting away, friend? Oh, there you go. Good job, Alejandro.
Green. Green is cool. Ta-da.
Hey, let me see, Alejandro.
I cut it into pieces, but.
Excellent. How are you doing, Genesis?
G. This one?
Hey, this sounds cool from Tingler. Jenny, excuse Rob's ill.
Now you're doing blue? Okay.
Making music.
Excited.
Rachel.
Excited.
How about making music? Loopy loopy loo. Haha, caught it with the pieces. Time to put him in the picture.
Anna, are you there?
Go over here.
This is frozen.
With my white out. By each other, and I'm
this one is not from Frozen.
No, this one is. Yeah, it's from Frozen. Do you want to build a snowman?
It's from Anna. Love to play in the snow.
Continue.
Hi, Miles. Miles.
Yes, I love Nemo.
My, oh, good. You've got your project.
She's listening. I'm a happy couple or else she went at Anna and got hurt. He was freezing.
Okay, Miles, are you ready to cut out some triangles? You're going to cut out your triangles, Miles. And then you're going to match the bead. The blue one's the bead.
On a scale. Six.
The orange one's to O. The green one's to G. Miles, oh, there we go. Good job. Good job, Genesis.
Someday went out to sea.
Into
day.
How did they do, Miss?
Oh, nice.
About cutting it out and putting it on my wall.
You could do that. Okay, now different quilt patterns have different names. Who can read the name of this one?
Pinwheel.
Pinwheel. Does it look like the toy, the pinwheel that you blow around?
Yes.
I've never seen a pinwheel before.
You've never seen me to show you one? I have one.
Whoa.
Let me go get it.
Excellent. How are you, Brandon? Oops, did a piece fall? Good job, Miles. I can see you cutting. Okay, cut out your triangles. To the pieces.
Well, this isn't the one I wanted, but.
Yeah, but it's the same, kind of the same idea.
Oh, cool.
Alejandro, look. Teacher Jennifer has a pinwheel.
A pinwheel?
No. Yeah. This looks like a flower. Flower.
Yeah, but do you see how it kind of looks like a pinwheel toy that would spin around? And the people who made these, they would have used little scraps of fabric wherever they could get them. Like if clothes wore out, they could cut up old clothes. There you go. Excellent.
And the last one.
How are you doing, Miles? Miles, how come your hands aren't working, silly?
You can do it, Miles.
We were working on not putting the scissors in our mouth for a second.
Oh, that's a really good thing to work on.
Are you ready to help me? Show me safe hands with your scissors, dude.
Yeah, you could cut all the pieces out, Miles, and then glue them on, and then the scissors.
Hey, we're gonna use safe hands with our scissors, okay?
I like it, Alejandro.
No.
We have just a couple.
Yes, I completed.
You completed it? I'm so proud of you. Okay, Alejandro, did you have fun? Was it hard?
No. To make things whole again.
How are you coming, Brendan? Brendan, let me see.
Brendan, let me see. Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Brendan, pinwheel.
Well done.
Wish well
done, yes. Well, yeah.
Did you draw another picture, Brendan?
High five.
High five. Oh, Miles, I see you working hard.
It's called a pinwheel.
Yeah. And you could do like Miss Jennifer if you want. You could cut it out. There's
what do you think of mine?
I think it's wonderful.
Yes.
It's a wonderful project. Right, Miles. It is a little tricky. You have to turn the triangle in just the right spot. You're doing a great job, Mr. Taco.
Taco, taco, man.
Yeah. Good job, Miles. And then I've read this book once before, but it's such a good one that if you want, I can read it again.
Now we have a little bit of time, yeah.
It's called The Quilt Story, because that's what you just made. And it talks kind of about the Oregon Trail, too. All right. A little girl's mother made the
quilt
to keep her warm. When the snow came down long ago, she stitched the quilt by a yellow flame, humming all the time. She stitched the tails of falling stars, and she stitched the name Abigail. So who was the quilt for?
Abigail.
Abigail loved the quilt. She wrapped it round her in the quiet dark and watched the winter skies. Sometimes she saw a falling star. Sometimes Abigail played in the woods near her home. She had tea. Her dolls had tea, and the quilt had tea all over it. Oops. Sometimes she pretended the quilt was a gown. She wore it to town on her horse, clop, 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 and it tore. So her mother stitched it up once more. Sometimes she played hide and seek with her sisters. She laughed and cried and hid under the quilt. And everyone found her. Sometimes Abigail was sick. She sneezed and sneezed. Then she slept under the quilt and she felt better. One day, Abigail's family moved away across wide rivers and over a rock hard trail. Okay, what are they traveling in?
A wagon.
A covered wagon, just like we saw on the movie. The quilt went too. Not stuffed in trunks with the blankets and clothes, it kept the little girls warm from the wild winds, warm from the rain, warm from the sparkling nights. Because the quilt was light, they could carry that. they built a new house in the woods. Abigail's father built it with his hatchet. Chop, chop, chop. He built her a new bed. Chop, chop, chop. He made her a new horse, too. And she worked until curly shavings covered the floor, and everyone sneezed and said, "Welcome home," and was glad. And Abigail felt sad. New house, new horse, new bed. Everything smelled of fresh chops and chips. Everything but the quilt. So her mother rocked her as mothers do, then tucked her in, and Abigail felt at home again under the quilt. One day, when the quilt was very old and very loved, Abigail folded it carefully and put it in the attic. Everyone forgot it was there. A gray mouse came and loved the quilt. Her babies were born on top of it. They grew fat and gray in the warm stuffing. When they got hungry, they ate a falling star. A raccoon came and loved the quilt. She dug a hole in a corner with her black paws and hid an apple there. A cat came and loved the quilt. A patchwork.
One dog cart.
It rolled on the stars and stuffing spilled out like snow. Then the cat curled up in the snow and purred.
Young Brian and love the quilt.
Kitty, kitty, called the little girl. She found her cat and she found the quilt. Splashed with patterns of sun. This isn't Abigail. I think it might be her great-granddaughter, maybe. But the little girl wrapped the quilt around her. She loved it too. Can you make it new? She asked her mother. So her mother patched the holes. She pushed the fresh stuffing in. She stitched long tails on the stars to swish across the quilt again. One day, the little girl's family moved away across miles and miles of pavement and snaking gray highways. Now, what were they in?
A car.
A car.
Car.
A long time later, because Abigail's grandmother or great-grandmother came in a covered wagon, but Abigail is moving in a car. They found a new house, freshly cleaned, freshly waxed, freshly painted, white. They unpacked and unpacked all night, and everyone sneezed on cardboard dust and said, "Welcome home," and was glad. And the little girl was sad. Everything smelled of white paint and boxes, everything but the quilt. So her mother tucked her, rocked her, as mothers do, then tucked her in, and she felt at home again under the quilt. Who's sleeping with her on the quilt? Who's sharing it with her?
Okay.
And there's Abigail.
Help, baby!
The end. The end.
I do like that story.
Quilt, but I have my blankie.
You have a blankie, yeah.
I remember that when I was a baby.
Yeah. Oh, it looks like Miles is frozen up there. I was going to have him show us his. Looks like he's almost done.
Yes, it's looking good.
Mm-hmm.
Whoops. But
frozen up.
Well, maybe he'll come back.
Yeah. All right.